My name is Braj Patel, and today I will explain you about the Beer's theorem. Now let us understand the Beer's theorem with the help of a simple example. Consider that there are two bags, bag 1 and bag 2. Bag 1 contains 2 white and 3 red balls. And bag 2 contains 4 white and 5 red balls. One ball is drawn at random from one of the bags. Now we can find the probability of selecting any of the bags, that is 1 by 2, or the probability of drawing a ball of a particular color, say white, from particular bag, say bag 1. In other words, we can find the probability that the ball is drawn of a particular color if we are given the bag from which the ball is drawn. But can we find the probability that the ball is drawn from a particular bag, say bag 2, and if the color of the ball drawn is given? Now here we have to find the reverse probability of bag 2 to be selected when an event occurred after it is known. Now to find this reverse probability, we have to use the formula of the Beer's theorem, that is P of Bi upon A is given as P of Bi into P of A given Bi upon P of B1 into P of A given B1 plus P of B2 into P of A given B2 plus P of Bn to P of A given Bn. Now what is event A? Event A is the event which has been occurred, that is, drawn ball is a red ball. Now B1, B2 are the events, that is, now first of all the bags are selected at random. So B1 must be the event that the ball was drawn from bag 1. And B2 that the ball is drawn from bag 2. Now the probability of B1 is half, as there are two bags. So the probability of selecting one bag is 1 by 2. And therefore probability of B2 is also 1 by 2. Now probability of A given B1, that is the event B1 occurring in the influence of event A. That is, now we can see in the bag 1 that there are 3 red and 2 white balls. So the probability of selecting red ball is 3 by 5. And probability of A given B2, that is the probability of event B2 occurring in the influence of event A. And we can see in the bag 2 that there are 5 red and 4 white balls. So the probability of selecting red balls is 5 by 9. Now it is given that the drawn ball is red. And to find the probability that the drawn ball is red and it is from the bag 2, it is given according to the Beer's theorem. So probability that drawn ball is red from bag 2 is given Now P of B1 given A is equals to P of B1 into P of A given B1 upon P of B1 to P of a given B1 plus P of B2 into P of a given B2. P of B1 given A is equals to half into 3 by 5 upon half into 3 by 5 plus half into 5 by 9. That's equals to 3 by 10 upon 3 by 10 plus 5 by 18. Now taking the LCM. So the LCM is 90. 3 by 10. Now that's 27 up plus 18, 5, 25 upon 90. That's equals to. So 3 by 10 upon 52 by 90 is equals to 270 upon 520. That is 27 upon 52 is equals to P of B1 given A. This is the probability that the red ball is drawn from the bag 1. This is randomly selected. Now, we will see how to apply the Bayes theorem. Now, this is an example. Suppose that the reliability of HIV test is specified as follows. Of people having HIV, 90% of the test detect the disease, but 10% go undetected. Of the people free of HIV, 99% of the tests are judged HIV negative, but 1% are diagnosed as showing HIV positive. From a large population, only 0.1% have HIV, 1% is selected at random and given the test and is reported HIV positive. What is the probability that a person actually has HIV? Now we will elaborate a sum with the help of a tree diagram. That is, here are the people having actually HIV and the people who were not having HIV. And the test was conducted and the people who were actually having HIV and got detected, the probability is 90%, that is 0.9. And people were having actually HIV, but the disease went undetected. That is, the probability of that is 0.1. Now the people who are not having HIV and the test detected that they are having HIV, the probability of that is 99%, that is 0.99. And the probability of the people who are not having HIV, and here the probability is 0.01. Now the people having actually HIV, and it was from a large population, it was shown that the people having HIV was at the probability 0.1%, that is 0.001. And so here the probability of people not having HIV from that large population is 0.999. Now the event A. Now our event A is that the chosen person is declared as HIV positive. Chosen person is declared HIV positive. Now our event B1, that is the person is actually having HIV positive. Having HIV positive, and B2 having actually HIV negative. Actually having HIV negative. Now from the tree diagram we can see that the probability of B1 event is 0.9 and probability of B2 event is 0.01. Probability of A given B1, that is under the influence of event A, is 0.001, and probability of A given B2 is 0.001. probability of A given B2 is 0.999. Now, according to the Bayes theorem, we have to find that the probability the person is randomly selected, and we have to find that the probability that the person is actually having HIV. So, probability of B1 given A is probability of B1 into probability of A given B1, 1, probability of B1 into probability of A given B1 plus probability of B2, probability of A given B2, that is 0.9 to 0.001 upon 0.9 into 0.001 plus 0.01 into 0.999, that's equals to 0.083. That is the probability that a person is randomly selected and he has actually the HIV positive.